Scar trying to figure who invented this unprecedented opium scented dark tinted. Now watch me blow him out of shoes without
going on. What's going on, YouTube? It's me again, Charles Torpedo. And I'm back. And I noticed a lot of people are doing videos about the most disturbing movies they've ever seen in their collection, their top 10 most disturbing. I'm going to go ahead and take a stab at that, take a little stabby stab at that, and just name off some of the most disturbing movies I've ever seen that are in my collection. Not really a top 10 or anything, or not really all mainstream. I just picked a stack that I thought were the most disturbing that I've seen. So I'll just go ahead and get this started with Salo. And I just have to say, if you've seen this movie and if this is not in the back of your mind or in your mind as one of the most disturbing movies you've ever seen, then there is something seriously fucking wrong with you. You really seriously need some professional intervention. This movie is basically about people in power getting off on torturing and degrading younger, lesser powerful people, basically. It includes everything from eating human feces, peeing on another human being, sodomy. At the end, there's a whole bunch of other shit that goes on. I know a dude gets his eye cut out. It's just fucking disgusting. And it's one of those movies where it's like, you're shocked at the level of depravity, how low human beings will stoop, and how, and you kind of wonder how another human being can treat another human being the way they do in this movie. But this is a movie that I think needs to be seen. I can't really give a reason why. Maybe just say you saw it, but it there's a lot of underlying things going on in here. A lot of, I guess, little messages that Pasolini was trying to get across. Definitely shocking and, like it says, nauseating, and easily one of the most disturbing movies I've ever seen, period. So, but it, I guess it's highly recommended, but at the same time, I wouldn't just recommend it to anybody. Anyway, next up, The Untold Story, a movie I saw recently. Glad I picked it up. Worth every cent I paid for it. And basically, I'm not going to really tell what it's about, but there's a scene in here where Anthony Wong's character pretty much slaughters an entire family. I mean, a little girl gets her head chopped off. And he practically rapes dude's wife in front of him and slaughters the rest of the kids. Just fucking disgusting and disturbing. And also, there's like some inadvertent cannibalism going on in here too. He chops up some bodies of some of the victims that he has and puts them into these barbecue pork buns. And the cops that are actually investigating him actually eat these pork buns. Of course, they don't realize they're eating human flesh, which, I mean, is kind of funny considering the scene that they're in, and they're talking about how they like it and how it tastes good and shit. But definitely one to check out if you're into disturbing films and just well-made Asian horror film, basically. Highly disturbing, though. Next up is David Cronenberg's Naked Lunch, film based off of William Burroughs' unfilmable novel, Naked Lunch. And it's basically about this guy that gets hooked on bug powder and sees all these hallucinations. He gets caught up in this world of Inner Zone where he's trying to solve some mystery. I forget what he's actually trying to do, but this movie is just filled with bizarre and very disturbing imagery. There's talking roaches that talk out of their ass. There's these things called mugwumps, and the ending scene is a bunch of mugwumps sitting there, and there's human beings basically sucking on their sexual organs and basically sucking out mugwump semen or jism or whatever. It's pretty fucking disgusting. And there's another scene where Julian Sands' character. Julian Sands is in this, the guy from Warlock. But he's in this. He plays a gay dude. And there's a scene where he's, I guess Cronenberg is trying to show that they're having sex. He and another dude are having sex. But what you see is what Peter Weller's character is seeing. Peter Weller's hopped up on bug powder. And he walks into the room and he sees like a giant centipede like creature absorbing another man from behind. It's really hard to describe that scene, but it's one of the most bizarre, fucked up looking things I've ever seen in my life in a movie. And it's really a movie you gotta see to believe. You can't describe this movie in any way, shape, or form. I did my best. That's all I'm gonna say. I mean, if you like Cronenberg, this is definitely a movie you should see, and it's probably my favorite Cronenberg joint, up there with Videodrome. But anyway, next up is Man Bites Dog, kind of a black comedy, dark comedy, about this a camera crew that follows around the serial killer, who goes into detail about how he kills, why he kills, who he kills, and even talks about how he gets rid of the bodies, and they even film a rape happening. And I believe even the camera crew gets involved in that rape. Pretty disturbing shit, but at the same time, there's parts in it that are actually pretty funny. Another movie I can't really recommend highly enough. You need to see it. Next up we have Happiness. Another movie where it's like a bunch of different storylines kind of intertwining, I guess. One involves Philip Seymour Hoffman's character, and I forget what he actually did for a living, but there's a scene in the movie where he rubs one out and uses his I don't even like talking about some of the stuff in this movie because it's so fucking disgusting. Where he uses his semen as like a glue. Like I put up sticky notes to remind yourself to do things. He uses his semen to stick up sticky notes on the wall to do things. And there's another scene where this little boy is discovering himself. I mean, like I said, I don't even like talking about it because it's so fucking wrong and disgusting. The little boy is discovering himself at the end of the movie, and it involves a dog. And I don't want to really describe it too much, and I can't really describe it and have it make any sense. It's just a movie you got to see to believe. In that ending scene with the little boy and the dog is one of those scenes you're probably going to be laughing hard at, but at the same time you're going to be questioning why you're laughing at it because it's so fucked up. But anyway, Happiness, highly recommended, very disturbing. Next up, Irreversible. Pretty much everyone knows about this. Film the reverse. These two guys get revenge for one of the dude's girlfriend who gets raped. And they go into this bar called the Rectum. It's a gay bar. One of the dudes smashes the dude's head in with a fire extinguisher. And, yeah. Pretty disturbing stuff. Pretty dizzying stuff. And the other notable thing in that movie is that long, drawn-out rape scene. Very, very hard to watch. Next up, got Fando and Liz, Alejandro Jodorowsky film, and this is one of those movies that I thought was disturbing just mainly because of the imagery. It's the closest thing that I've seen as far as a movie trying to portray a dream that actually seemed like a dream. And as the movie goes on, it's more like a nightmare. It's basically about this couple. They're trying to find this mythological city of Tar, and they encounter cross-dressers, old women just randomly playing cards in the middle of nowhere, a fucking dominatrix throwing bowling balls at them and shit, a blind dude and another dude who drinks blood. It's really hard to describe this movie, and I'm sorry. But my mind was blown to bits after watching this. It's just so insane. and I guess it started riots at the theater that it was shown at when it was premiered. So, I mean, if that doesn't spark your interest, like I said before, I don't know what does, but highly recommend this. All of Jodorowsky's work is highly recommended. But I'm going to go ahead and stop it there. I got a few more to show, but stay tuned for this next part.